button, tarnation!
Howdy, folks, this is Applegeek, and here we are with more My Little Pony the Movie content. I was not expecting another trailer to come out for this, but here we are, the second or third trailer, depending on how you feel like numbering it. The first teaser thing wasn't even really a trailer, so this is only the second one, really, but whatever. However you want to number it, it doesn't really matter. But I've been waiting all day to get home to see this, because I saw it this morning. I saw it announced this morning, and like I gotta work today, so as I do most days of the week. So yeah, now I'm finally home from work, and now I finally get a chance to watch it, all the while having people hyping it up for me. So yeah, I'm just gonna stop rambling here and give this a watch, and then I'm sure I will have plenty more to say. So My Little Pony movie trailer number, I'm calling it number 2, starting now.
All this power.
Seen that before? Oh yeah.
Stood on parties when there were far greater uses.
Ooh.
I don't think those are storm clouds.
Those visual effects.
Put your hooves together for Commander Tempest.
Seen this?
Here's the deal, ladies. I need your magic.
Oh! Oh! I love that laugh.
Do you have the princess?
Nice.
She might have got away a little bit.
I feel alive.
We need help to save Equestria.
We're ready to kick some booty.
Pirates?
Yes. Yes. Ooh, that rainbow.
Painted pink.
Nice touch.
Hey, Scout.
Y'all ready to do this thing?
Come on.
Hey, we got his voice.
I want to help too.
And her voice. I love the parrot. I love that guy.
Now.
I hate epic adventures.
Are they getting flushed down the drain?
We've got this together.
This is intense.
Yeah.
This ends now.
Big old party cannon. Yes! Yes! This movie would not be complete without some awesome rarity drama there. Oh, wow. Yeah, definitely a lot of interesting new little scenes there. I'm gonna have to pick this apart a little bit. I'm not gonna go too crazy like I did last time, but I do want to watch this again and check out a few things here and come back and talk about them. Just one little thing I caught right at the end there. Interesting that they credited Spike, or Kathy Westlake for Spike, as Spike the Dragon. So, I like that. It's a fancier title for him than just Spike. But anyway, I'm going to watch this again. I will probably a few times, and I will be right back for you guys. Alright, everyone. I am going to do my best to keep this brief. Like I said earlier, I didn't want to go too terrible deep into this one. And the big deep picking things apart was done last trailer. Some of the footage from that was recycled in this one, things we already know. So it's not really a whole lot of new stuff that I need to dive into here. Even some of the new scenes we saw, they're fun and interesting. They don't really add much to the story. I have been seeing and hearing some things that's corrected some of the theories and whatnot that I've had about the course of the story based off the first trailer. I've also had some new theories generated as a result. You know, some of the stuff, I don't want all the stuff to be answered before I watch the movie. I'm trying to be careful not to get into too many spoiler stuff. I do have, like, the prequel comics. I haven't actually read them yet. I'm honestly not sure if I even want to before I get to the movie, but we'll see on that. But anyway, I will just say there are a few things that I need to talk about here, though. So I do have a few screen caps, not too terrible many. I'll try and get through these quick here. The biggest one, and this I'm sure you're all just really hoping that I caught this. I caught this immediately on second watch. I actually thought that it looked like something important on first watch, but it went by so fast I didn't catch it. This here. This is serious. Celestia frozen in something? I turned to stone, maybe? Is this like a Star Wars thing? I don't know what's going on here, but a buddy of mine did point out that some of these movie toys that come out, there's a set of pony figurines that show the princesses in like these like black and grayish forms. And he wondered if it was going to be foreshadowing of something in the movie. He was right. He was dead on with that assumption. Now we know basically why the princesses are not going to be around to help with this, why the main six are on their own, apparently. And this just has far bigger implications regardless, because if they have the power, whatever kind of magic power this army is harnessing, I mean, clearly it's not Tempest's power because she's got a broken horn. It looks like she does have the ability to use her magic to some degree, but it's basically just like raw pure energy shooting out as like lightning bolts or something. So it's basically just destructive raw power. So whatever's going on here, for them to be able to take out Alicorn princesses, this is a threat like none we've ever seen before. This is beyond Tyrek. I mean, this is serious stuff. So it's probably dumb luck that Twilight and friends actually even got away so that they got a chance to, you know, find some allies and come and fight back. So, and in that regard, we got an interesting new scene here of the airships. This, I'm pretty sure we didn't see this before. This looked new to me. And this really raises the stakes, because I only thought there was one airship. There's three airships here, and who knows how many others may be in the armada. This is a whole armada that's attacking. It's no wonder this is a serious threat to them. And for Tempest to come out and say this, like, you know, hey ladies, you know, okay, ladies, I need your magic. What for? This is not just a coming back for revenge thing. Like, this is an invasion force. They are coming for the pony magic for something. I don't know if it's just to get Tempest's own magic power restored, or if it's something even bigger and more nefarious. Probably is. Whatever it is, it isn't good. So clearly they already have some magic power for them to be wanting even more. Ooh. So yeah, big problem there. This, I loved this shot. This needs to be like movie poster artwork right here. Just like this face in the dark like this, and the date across the bottom, that should be a movie poster, because this is intimidating. I said, and just the visual effects of this lightning from the broken horn and stuff, it's just amazing. I probably shouldn't even call it lightning, it's raw energy, basically. It's just... wow. I said, this movie is going places that My Little Pony has never gone before. That's... you know, it's a bit of a... sounds like a Star Wars cliche, but it's true. To boldly go where no pony has gone before, whatever. Yes, that was horrible. This is not from the trailer, but I just had to share this. This is a still from the movie that was released very recently, and this actually confirms one of my new theories. I noted before that Pinky looked like she is really stepping up as a leader in a lot of the scenes and stuff that we were shown, and especially in scenes where it looked like Twilight wasn't even present. And it occurred to me, it's like, hey, I bet Twilight maybe gets kidnapped at some point, or taken prisoner, and this scene appears to confirm that. It certainly looks like Tempest has got Twilight by herself in some sort of a prison cell cage thing there. So, again, the visual effects in this thing are just off the chart amazing. The airships do still look a little bit odd with that CG animation, but I'm honestly not going to complain about that too much. I've seen far worse. So, anyway. Moving on. Epic shot of the pirates. I got to see a little bit more of them. I cannot wait to see this band of pirates. They look awesome. and really, there's one other scene with doing some sort of like song at the table or something. Rarity and Fluttershy seem to be really getting into this, and it's interesting seeing those two paired together like this. We haven't really seen
those two paired off together in episodes very much before. So that's an interesting character combination. But just... Well, Fluttershy is probably enjoying herself just because of the fact it's parrots. You know, it's birds. I don't know. But Rarity, I'm sure she's like super inspired with all the pirate, you know... couture chic, whatever, their style of clothing and whatever is getting lots of inspiration for the outfits. I don't know where that hat came from, but yeah, I can't wait to see them putting together the pirate outfits. This, I will only say, Rainbow Dash, you look way too happy for the food that is in front of you. this one here, the pink fingernails or claws or whatever they are on these henchmen. Clearly Tempest was not impressed with those. I have no idea what's going on there. Who, how, where, when, why. I can't wait to see that though, because it looks like somehow the ponies or somebody starts to turn the army or something. I almost kind of makes me think it's related to the scene we saw at the end of the first trailer. The Storm King was talking about, you know, flowers and ponies and blah. So, yeah. Interesting. This, what is going on here? It looks like they're getting flushed down a giant drain. And it occurred to me, this is probably where they're about to enter Sequestria, the undersea kingdom of the sea ponies, or hippocamps, or whatever you'd like to call them. So, I was wondering how they were going to get down there. The answer is quite rapidly, it looks like. But, Princess Skystar got to finally hear her voice a little bit, and Capra's voice, and some of these characters we were missing before. I really hope... Clearly there's a song going on here. I really hope this is Shubidoo. I don't care what anyone says. I don't care how horrible the song kind of is. It's one of those songs that's so horrible it's awesome, and I actually think it's kind of catchy. Desperately wanting that song to be remixed and brought into this new movie. It better be in there somewhere. I will be disappointed. So we'll just have to see. But definitely looks like they have some fun there. And yeah, Skystar said, it was like, I want to help. So I'm curious as to how many of the sea ponies actually do go with to help them, though. Yeah, the Storm King. I really wish we'd gotten a little bit more footage of him. But, you know, all we got in the first trailer is him just saying, you know, having, like, one line, and it was rather goofy, so I wasn't sure, like, is this guy actually the true villain or not? Here we see him in what appears to be a combat situation, so he looks pretty serious, so I'm gonna say that he is definitely a decent villain in this. What the outcome is gonna be with him, I have no idea, but he's going down somehow. I just can't wait to see how. Now, this is interesting, too. I will point out the backgrounds of this scene and the backgrounds of this scene as well. This looks to me like the ruins of Canterlot Castle. So those stained glass windows, what's left of the archways and stuff. I'm pretty sure that this looks like what's the left of the throne room, basically. And we saw in the last trailer that they were... launching an all-out, you know, megastorm attack on Canterlot, so it looks like the castle gets wrecked pretty bad. We also saw, you know, those cottages and stuff with, like, damaged roofs and whatever, so, yeah, that's very unfortunate, but, again, this movie is going places we haven't seen Pony go before, and, you know, I'm sure they'll rebuild bigger and better than ever, yada yada. And I've heard a rumor, I've heard that somebody told me that they saw a tweet somewhere that supposedly confirmed that Season 8 will have continuity with the movie. I really hope that's true, because this new castle, even before it gets wrecked, this new castle looks way too important with the changes that they made that equalized Celestia and Luna. That's a very important thing. I want that to be represented in the show following this movie somehow. So... curious to see where that goes. But I think this is towards the end of the movie. I mean, just, you know, you've got all the main six here looking very confident again, finally, because clearly they were not confident at the beginning and whatnot. So this looks like Pinky's got this wonderfully, like, evil grin on her face like I've never seen before. It's pretty much looks like the scene like, yeah, we win. So, yeah, it should be a very interesting ending to this movie, I would think. Anyway, I was gonna say too, while back here, I didn't get a screenshot of it, but Grubber with the scene is like, did you let the princess escape? Well, not really. Well, maybe just a little bit. It's like, either she escaped or she didn't. There is no amount of escaping. I saw an interview, or I read an interview just recently here that somebody did with Megan McCarthy regarding this movie, and some of the stuff she was telling about the process of writing it and stuff was very interesting. And she mentioned that Michael Peña, that they'd brought him in as Grubber, were just wanting him to be like the comic relief to you know, like the opposite of Tempest in this, less like, you know, taking some of her seriousness and adding some humor to it to lighten it up a little bit. And apparently he's just doing all manner of like crazy funny lines and ad-libbing a lot of the stuff, and a lot of that ended up in the movie. So I just know I'm gonna love Grubber in this. He's gonna be awesome. So anyway, and just one final shot here. Is it just me, or does Rarity look like she's more of a marshmallow than ever? I mean that in the nicest possible way. I really did. Rarity is just really become an awesome character the last couple seasons, and this over the top epic drama from her in this is just absolutely perfect. I mean, you can tell Tabitha's really going all out in this one. Probably all the voice actors are in this. I mean, this is a really big deal for them too, to be in a feature film like this. So yeah, all the hype just keeps, you know, getting bigger and bigger on this. And as I said, I gotta cut myself off at some point, or else I'm gonna know the entire movie before going into it. I'm trying to allow myself to have a few surprises yet when I go see it finally. But yeah, this was definitely a very fun little trailer, and it'd be interesting to see all your guys' comments on it. And yeah, we're just a little over 3 weeks away from this, so it's almost here. I'm sure the time is gonna go quick. So yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this little recap with me here, and I will catch you again soon for more reactions. Later.